Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Kirby's Return to Dreamland. We're ready to start up level 5, Nutty Noon. And as you can see, we are running out of places to go here on Planet Popstar, so maybe something interesting will happen after this world. Let's not get too far ahead of ourselves, just go ahead and take this one stage at a time and start off with stage 1 here. You can see we've got 4 energy spheres, so we're going to have to be looking just a little bit, not too hard anyway. Alright, so I think, yeah, there's Parasol over here if you want it. Might as well take it since we don't really have anything at the moment. So let's go ahead and hop in the Warp Star and get a free ride up. Now, as you'll soon see, most of the levels in this world are kind of like cloud and sky themed. I mean, you can see just looking at the background, we are like way above the world right now, so... we're gonna be kind of up in the clouds a lot during this world, which is pretty cool. You know, it's pretty neat little stages. And some of them are actually, like, really peaceful and calming, so... it's actually kind of interesting, but I like it. So yeah, Parasol isn't actually too bad here. It's got a pretty good range in front of it, and, you know, it can do that diving attack. Sometimes, you know, anytime you do a dash attack like that, it can leave you open a little bit, but... that's just how it goes. And of course, we can float around, be all adorable if we want. This thing's following me, I don't like it. Oh, we have a chance to grab Whip, so I'm probably gonna do so. And I think we can use it to actually grab a 1-up in here as well. Yeah. And grab it, there we go. Alright, so, whoa, let's keep... I figured, like, I thought if you jumped into enemies, it would hurt them instead, but I don't know, maybe I was too, like, late on it or something. Alright, so, yeah, there's a couple opportunities to grab Wing here. You don't really see a lot of Wing enemies, but this bird thing will actually give it to you. So, I believe this is, like, one of the very first times we've been able to see that, if not the first time, actually. Aside from, I think, in one of the Howl rooms, perhaps, but... alright, so here it might be a good idea to grab Parasol because it kind of shields above you like this, and so, you know, if you happen to run into something, it'll generally take it out. So you really only have to worry about not running into the spiky things. Get in there. There you go. So yeah, pretty easy energy sphere here. That door is very obvious and that's easy to get to, so... first one is in the bag. Alright, so let's keep going up here. Yeah, it might be a good idea to, you know, take things slow just so you can see what's coming up. If you don't have Parasol, I mean, this is still doable. It's really not that bad, but, you know, Parasol just kind of helps out a bit. And, yeah, we can go up a little bit here, get some cake if we want. Awesome. Alright, so we got a couple choices here. I think I'm going to go with Spear, because I like that one. Yeah, now the only thing about these is the two powers they give you will cut these... branches here, as you can see, so you kind of have to be a little bit careful. You don't want to cut the platform out from under you and not be expecting it. So, you know, just make sure you watch where you attack, and also watch out for those things coming from the clouds. They can be easy to miss because they just kind of blend in, so it can be a little annoying sometimes. But if you want to play it safe, it might not be a bad idea to just fly through most of this, you know, just in case you do cut a platform you don't mean to. But, you know, it's not really that bad, so it's pretty simple. And you got plenty of time to react, so it's no big deal. Just drop those guys. Alright, so as we go up here, we're gonna need one of those powers to cut the vines, as you can see, because we have to get in this door. Alright, and there's, again, another energy sphere. That one's a little trickier to find, but still not too bad as long as you're just looking around, you know? Okay, yeah, that can be dangerous, doing the down attack, because you can't really, like, cancel it, so you could very well just throw yourself into the pit, you know? It's happened to me before, I'm sure. Alright, so the door to get out of here is up there. Okay, and of course, more cloud-like areas. Like I said, you find a lot of that stuff here. And there's Tornado here, which can actually be somewhat useful. It makes it really easy to get around these places, so I'm gonna do that. Because you're basically invulnerable while you're using the tornado attack, so you can just kind of use it to make your way up here, as long as you make sure not to actually just land on anything. And in this area, there's going to be a couple of these hidden passages off to the side. This one's just got stars, but I believe there's one later on that actually houses one of our energy crystals, so, or energy spheres, whatever they're called. Yeah, I think it's this one right here. Yep, there it is. I think we can't go back through that way. And I'm probably gonna grab Wing here. flying a little easier. Oh, I thought that would hit him. Alright, yeah, and here's this super happy music again. Alright, so we're gonna have these kind of giant rolling spiky balls, but they're pretty easy to avoid, especially if you have a power like Wing. It can go pretty fast. So, yeah, make sure you watch out for that. Of course, I lost the power, but well, that's how it goes. I'm just trying to be a little too speedy, I guess. Alright, now, there's gonna be one of these here, where you're gonna want to get ahead of this thing. It can be kind of hard. Actually, I don't think you have to get ahead of it. I just think you need to be somewhat quick behind it. Because it's going to destroy this block here, which will let you get up. There we go. And because you got to be fast. Otherwise, as you can see, the other one will block it off. And there's no other way to get down here. You can't drop through this. So just make sure to be somewhat quick there. Not as complicated as I was making it out to be, but oh well. Alright, so that finishes stage number one. Sweet, stage number two. Let's do it. Got another 4 energy crystals to be collecting here. Yeah, and this one's really cool. I like this. You know, it's kind of taking place at sunset. Everything's got this kind of reddish hue to it. It's pretty neat. And of course, they give us ninja here as well. So, you know, it's kind of hard to go wrong. The level looks cool. You get ninja right off the bat. That's going to be an awesome level. I love this power. It's so awesome in this game. They improved it so much from Kirby Superstar. Again, making references to that game, but, you know, just how it goes. Yeah, there's not too much you need to worry about here. I don't think there are any energy spheres or anything, so that's mostly just getting through it alive. Man, I love this power. It's awesome. Yeah, that dual attack where you do the slash and the shockwave is actually really strong, so it's a good one if you need to take out multiple enemies. There you go. See, that was it. I was trying to do it on that other guy, but it didn't work. Alright, now this part, yeah, you can take bomb if you want, but I wouldn't recommend it. Ninja is just so awesome, there's very little that beats it in this game. Yeah, just watch out for the bombs they throw, definitely. Alright, now we gotta take this thing, just be careful with it, because you can't fly, and these platforms are actually deceptively easy to miss and fall off of and other various bad things, so be a little bit careful with this thing. You've got plenty of time, though, there's no need to rush. So just make sure you wait until you're in good position to make a jump before you actually try it. There we go. Crap. Oh man, I knew that was gonna... I saw that as soon as I grabbed him. Ah, oh, that sucks. Oh well. That is a downfall to ninja, is that throw attack sometimes happens when you really don't want it to. So you know, I guess we're just gonna stick with bomb for now. Oops, yeah, I'm terrible with bomb in this game. Alright, so let's grab the big one here. Yeah, I was trying to get off those platforms because that bomb will damage you when it blows up, and I was standing close enough to it that it would have hurt me. So let's just try throwing it from here. Hopefully that'll blow up the big one. Yeah, cool. Alright, so this one we're gonna have to make a somewhat precise bomb throw. There we go. Nice, got a first try. Alright, so there's Energy Sphere number one. Let's get rid of bomb, because I really just don't want it. I'd rather have nothing, to be honest. Oh, grab this. Lock these guys out, and they'll just bump up against the wall trying to get you. That's awesome. I guess we'll take sword out. Oh, come on, dude, get over here. Alright, so of course, we got a couple of these things that we're gonna have to choose from. The choices are going to multiply. No, definitely take a ninja. and the one in the middle doesn't always destroy the middle one, as you can see. That one will actually take care of the right one. So I'm gonna get that burger. And okay, it was that one. I had no idea which one destroyed the bottom part. This one's second from the left. There we go. I guess we could try... Okay, no, that was the wrong one. I kinda wanna get that sandwich as well. Nope. Whoa, okay. Nope. Man, those things are annoying. Alright, well, didn't get so lucky that time, but that's alright. Oh, get off the wall. Alright, I think we're gonna have a mini-boss coming up soon, but I could be wrong. No, I believe it is right here. Yeah, sweet. And, ooh, it's against Mountain Dew. Let's see, like I said, that attack can be pretty strong. It's doing quite a lot of damage to him. And, of course, if he's chargy, you can't just sit here and spam these things. That also works. Of course, he's invulnerable while doing that attack, but... There we go. And like I've said before, defeat a mini-boss, make sure to take its powers, you're probably gonna need it, and in this case you do. There's gonna be some of those gray blocks that you can't, Oh no, okay, yeah, it's the little stump things, okay. So just make sure not to destroy the last one, otherwise it will block your path. So just go over, grab this one, and that's number two. And if I'm not mistaken, I think we're gonna get one of the superpowers in order to get the last two, but... Again, I could be wrong. You know, I'm going just pretty much completely off of memory with this part, so... And we'll see how it goes. Yeah, okay, we are going to. Alright, so let's grab the, flare beam here. And of course, we're gonna have to light these, little kind of star things. Not really sure what to call them, but... Just hit them all. You can take your time. As long as you hit them all before the flare beam runs out, you'll get credit for it. So, you know, they don't just go away after a certain amount of time or anything. God, that hat is ridiculous. I laugh pretty much every time I see it. And also, you can't get hurt while you're doing this, so don't even really worry about the Scarfies. They'll just kind of stand there. And you can destroy them all if you want. As you can get hurt coming out of it, so... Yeah, and those stars made a little face pattern as well. I guess we can get rid of these things. Alright, so as you can see, the number of stars we have to light up is increasing here. Oop, did that one. There we go. Nope, didn't even see that guy. Well, he's chasing after me, huh? Alright, so this is pretty much the biggest one on this level. We're gonna have even more later on, but for this one, this is the most you get. It's gonna be, as you can see, again, in the pattern of a big face. They like doing that. So that'll take care of all of them. And that'll raise up, revealing the little wormhole portal thing for us to go through. Still not sure exactly what that is, but it could be all scientific and call it a temporal distortion or something, but I don't know. Alright, so let's make our way through. Now this one, I'm pretty sure most of the idea is that we're gonna have to use these blocks to destroy the bomb blocks, so make sure not to use them all up. It's a good idea to shoot them one at a time because that gives you the fastest projectile and a lot more in case you miss. So, you know, if you shoot them all up, or if you inhale them all up, then, you know, you won't be able to get any more if you miss, so don't want to do that. Ah, crap, this could be bad. There we go, we got it. So yeah, they're pretty simple for the most part. I mean, they're pretty easy to hit, especially if you have the fastest, you know, projectile, but... Gotta do it that way. That was actually pretty good. Yeah, it should be the last one. Yep, there it is. So, pretty simple area as long as you don't, you know, completely screw yourself over. Alright, so yeah, I don't think stone would be very good to fight the flying thing with, so we'll go with parasol. And of course, the gimmick here is we're gonna have this platform moving back and forth, so be careful not to fall off, like I almost did. Yeah, and it also will drag you into them sometimes. Yeah, you gotta be a little careful with the dash attack on the parasol in this battle. Nope, far away. Yeah, just standing here with the parasol under him will hurt as well, so that's kinda cool. That's a fun way to kill him, just jump into him. Alright, so there we go. Takes care of all the energy crystals, spheres. I keep calling them that, I'm not sure why. For 5-2. Yep. Alright, so level exit should be just ahead here. Oh yeah, we got a little bit of cannoning to do. This is all automatic. But you get to plow through some enemies, so that's always fun. Nice. I love just the little, you know, the little touches, the little sections like that. That kind of that makes the game so much cooler. Alright, so let's see where the next stage is gonna be, just above us. Alright, the water challenge, of course. Alright, stage 3. Now, this is a really interesting music track, if you ask me. It's, like, so peaceful. Like I said, some of these levels can really be that way. So, just watch out for the wind here. It can blow you into enemies and spikes and stuff very easily. So, as you can see, there's spikes all around, so be somewhat careful. While you're on the ropes, though, the wind doesn't affect you, so that can be useful. Alright, yeah, see, the problem with this is we're gonna get blown to the right, so you want to wait till he goes to the left, so you don't just run into him because of the wind. Yeah, see, it kind of blows you all over the place here, so just be a little bit careful, but it's not too bad. And there's, of course, a couple health items over there if you really need it, but we don't, so let's just go through. Alright, now I get to go up. There's basically just a lot of cannons here. But before too long, we'll be presented with one of those giant cannon things you hold over your head. There it is. So I can make it a little trickier, because you gotta jump on these moving platforms and stuff. I don't think this is actually required to get a crystal, though. I'm pretty sure it's just for some health items and stuff at the top, so you probably don't really even have to do this if you don't want to. Because I'm pretty sure it's just to blow this open, yeah, and get all this stuff, so... it's not really necessary, I suppose. I mean, I didn't even take any damage there, so I didn't need them. Alright, it's a good idea to take that stone power if you can. Otherwise, the needle power does work pretty well here. As you can see, we're gonna have to beat this guy over to the bottom, so let's go ahead and get started. The stone power can help out because you fall a lot faster, but overall, this is still pretty easy. Just, you know, make sure you put the needle out when you do that, and, you know, there's really no trouble here. You move a lot faster than him, so pretty much no matter what power you have, you'll probably make it, but stone can help out. It's definitely nice. So at this point, we just wait. Take the key, and there we go. So there is energy sphere number one. Alright, now we're gonna have to climb up a bit and avoid these... wow, didn't even see that one coming. Avoid these giant electric cannon things here. We're gonna... okay, good thing. I was hoping there was a platform at the bottom there. We're gonna need beam. Man, I'm having all kinds of trouble with these for some reason. I'm just kind of rushing it a little bit, I think. Not really taking my time. Alright, so we're gonna need beam for a energy crystal in a bit. Why do I keep calling it crystal? I'm not sure what's going on there. Energy sphere. There we go. So obviously, don't get eaten by those things. It's pretty easy if you take your time. Although that one you need to move. Alright, so here's the one you need beam for. No, you can't do the dash attack. You gotta do just a regular jump. And hit it there. There we go. Alright, and this one, just make sure to take your time, because they put a lot of those things like at the ends of paths, as you can see, so... basically, any time, you know, you can see them coming, it's really not too tough, and you can kill them, just like that, so it's no big deal. Grab this thing at the end. So, pretty simple. Alright, so let's keep making our way up. Try not to get hit by any more of these. They take off a lot of health, so, and be a little bit careful here. Whoop. Alright, ooh, a high jump section. Sweet. So let's just keep going up. It's pretty simple. As long as you make sure not to land on any enemies, you'll be fine. Now, there is, I believe, a pretty tricky energy crystal to get here, so... there we go. Let's do it that way. No real need to actually go up that way, but, you know, it's... okay, yeah, I think, yeah, this is the tough one. As you can see, we've got this here, which is going to open that up, but only temporarily. You've only got a little bit of time. So once you get up there, there's a lever we're going to have to pull, so hopefully we can do this somewhat quickly. And then fall back down real quick. And see, that closes really fast, so... now, what I think you... okay, well, I'm pretty much screwed now, because you can't get back down there if that closes on you. Oh, well, you can. Oh, I didn't know that. Okay, well, that works, then. Okay, yeah, the high jump isn't really serving me very well there. There we go, we'll do it that way. There we go. That's what you're supposed to do. Kind of charge it up while you're falling a little bit, so you can just high jump as soon as you reach the bottom section. Alright, finally got it. That took a little while. That one's a little bit tricky, but we managed to pull it off, so it's good. Watch out for the rocky enemies there. Yeah, high jump is weird for killing enemies that are, like, horizontal to you. Oh, well, cool. See, I think we can actually break this without, yeah, without disturbing that guy's sleep, so we'll let him be. Whoa. Oh, man, I almost got away. Oh, wow, that was also close. Alright, there we go. Man, the wind was playing tricks on me a little bit. Alright, yeah, I'll take Wing. That's a pretty good power. And it's also a cleverly hidden energy crystal. Wow. Okay, energy sphere. I don't know. I haven't been playing any games that have energy crystals in them. I guess that's what, I don't know, thinking of maybe, well, no, because Mega Man, I was thinking Mega Man Legends, but no, those are refractors, so I don't know. Anyway, we got everything done there, so. Alright, so there should only be a couple more stages to go here in this world. And there we go. Okay, so yet another one with four energy spheres. Seems to be the theme going here. Oh yeah, this one's got a lot of these boots in it. I love it. Okay, well, meant to jump on the guy, but that's fine. Now, this first one, it doesn't really matter if you lose it. It's no big deal, because they're going to give you another one later on. But that one, I believe, you do need to keep for an energy sphere, so make sure to do so. Oop. Well, it wasn't the prettiest in the world, but we made it. Yeah, see, they give you another one here. But this one I do believe you need, so try not to lose it. Get the one up there. Yeah, see, because we have to make our way along those spiky dudes down there. There's a wind current that'll blow you up if you try to fly. And obviously, you know, you can only hop across them with the boot, so definitely need that. We are done with it for now, but I'm gonna keep it for a little while. I think we're gonna have to ditch it here anyway, yeah, because we gotta climb up. Alright, so just take your time, try not to rush, because the cannons will hit you if you just keep going. They're programmed that way. Oh, that'll work. Watch out for these arrow dudes. You can pretty much just keep going there and not worry about them. Alright, so for this energy sphere, it's easiest to just wait until the left one fires, because there's kind of a little break after that. So you just drop down, get it, and go back up. You know, it's pretty easy. There's plenty of time to go get it. Alright, whoa! Okay, that was kind of close. So yeah, just pull that, break these things, and go in the door. Alright, let's see. Fire or ice? Or wing? You know, yeah, we'll take fire. That's pretty good. I get the feeling there's a mini-boss coming up. And yeah, there definitely is. This is certainly a mini-boss arena. So I wasn't sure, because Wing is kind of a weird one for bosses. It can be pretty good, but you have to really know how to use it. And I'm not exactly that experienced with it. But fire is good, because you can just keep up a constant stream of attacks at pretty good range. Just make sure to move whenever he tries to jump on you. Oh, man. Okay, no, I meant to try to get the fire there. There we go. I have trouble getting it back for some reason. Oh, man. It's taking forever. Fire's, it's kind of weak, though. That's the only downside to it. Each attack doesn't really do a lot of damage. But we get the Grand Hammer out of it, so that's definitely good. And obviously how we're going to get our last two energy spheres, so it's awesome. And this is a pretty fun one, as far as the superpowers go. This is definitely one of my favorites. So get some health recovery over here. And of course, you see the giant poundable things with the stars on them, you know what to do. So yeah, doing that will oftentimes open up alternate pathways. Oh, cool. I got kind of lucky on that one. So hey, got a couple lives, nice. And no, I don't think you have to power up the hammer all the way, but I mean, why wouldn't you? It's so cool. So take out these things, and I believe once we pound this bottom one here, this platform's gonna start moving up. Yeah, there we go. Whoa. Thought it was gonna throw me right into the cannonball there. Of course, we got these giant... Oh, they're not as big. They are still kind of larger cannons, but they're not exactly giant cannons. So we got a couple recovery here. Spring will shoot us up, I believe. I think this is what's going to take us to the other dimension world thing. Like I said, it's little sections like this that make this game so cool. So you go up, break the bell, and as you can see, that'll open it up. So let's do it. Alright, oh yeah, this one's got a bunch of moving platforms. Thankfully, it's not so bad if you're not really trying to get through it, like, as quickly as possible. Because, you know, the purple wall, like, we're not even seeing it, and we're just flying, so... You can pretty much just hold down the jump button for a large part of this. But, you know, of course, there are a couple sections where you can't quite do that. I love the giant waddle-dee there. But, you know, there's really no point in dealing with all these moving platforms. That would be a pain. Well, we can get through it, you know, pretty safely just this way. Just gotta knock him off there. See, we're encountering basically no resistance. So, I don't know. I guess they could have afforded to make the ceiling a little bit lower. This one can be tricky, as long as you just shoot him and then... I still messed it up, but you can usually shoot him and then just, like, mash the jump button and you'll get back into flight before hitting any of the other ones, but... Anyway, we made it, so let's see, we've got whip or spear. I'm gonna take spear. A little more precise. But you do have to watch out, because these platforms will move apart and eventually move back together. If you're caught in between them when they're moving back together, you will get crushed and die, so that's obviously not good either. But it's easy to not really be paying attention to them. Oh man, totally had him there. It's also easy to not be paying attention when they move apart and end up falling down as well, so... you know, just pay somewhat a little bit of attention to the floor, but otherwise not too bad. So that marks the last two for this stage. Let's grab the Maximum Tomato and get out of here. Alright, so it looks like, again, like I said, we're gonna be up in the clouds a lot in this world. You can see we've gotten up pretty high, though. It almost looks like we're in outer space or something. That's kinda cool. And of course, I will definitely take Fighter if they're gonna give it to me. Let's go. Should get an extra life from this. Alright, so let's see, is there another stage or is this the boss? Ah, I guess there's another stage. It's got some more copy abilities. I think that's a pretty good one. I believe that one has Fighter. Don't quote me on that, though. I didn't really look at the picture that in-depth. Now, this one is sort of a different level, because this is the final one before the boss. I don't know how I forgot about this one, but... basically, we're gonna be just climbing this tower and fighting a bunch of mini-bosses along the way. If you want to get all the energy crystals, really all you have to worry about is taking the powers of each boss after each battle, and you'll be able to get it in the next room. So, unfortunately, we can only really use Fighter for this first guy, but that's how it goes. Oh, that's exactly what I meant to do. Yeah, and of course this music should be familiar for anyone who's played any of the Kirby games. This is mostly the theme that plays when you're about to fight King Dedede, so... But yeah, as you can see, these energy spheres are pretty easy to get. All you have to do is just make sure you have the right power. So it's pretty simple. The only problem is you have to use that power to fight the next guy. Or I guess you could take that one. I really would have rather had Spear. I wonder if I can respawn him. Yeah, cool. I love when it does that. So let's see, next up we've got Moundo again. Yeah, we're kind of fighting the same mini-bosses over and over, but... Yeah, Spear's pretty good for him, because you can attack him while keeping a decent distance. You know, if he does something unexpected or, you know, charges at you or something. This. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna have to fight the next mini-boss. Well, no, we'll see what comes up in the next room. I was gonna say we're gonna have to fight him using stone, but we might not. Just depends on what comes up. These energy spheres are pretty much automatic if you just take the power, so it's kind of a nice break there. Stone or beam? Honestly, I'd rather have stone. Stone is pretty powerful. It does a decent amount of damage. And if we kind of get it on the edge here... Yeah, see, the only problem is when this happens. Like, you'll damage him when you come out of it, but you're pretty much guaranteed to get hit. And he's not gonna move. Okay, well, that'll work. But see, if you get it pretty much right on the edge, you can sit there and do this. Oh, crap. Well, at this point, he's almost dead. Oh, crap. Let's do this. Alright, so yeah, that was a little iffy, but it went faster than it probably would have if I got beamed, so... Alright, so we got some blocks. Obviously, we need to cool off here. And do it this way. This is pretty much the fastest way to take care of those blocks. Right, so there's number three. Now hopefully there's something other than water I can fight this next guy with. Sword. Ah, well, we'll stick with water then. That's fine. Oh yeah, and it's Dubior. Yeah, this guy would have been pretty hard with sword, actually. That little rainbow attack that you do by holding down and then pressing up, it's pretty powerful. You can see it does a lot of damage. So, you know, it's a decent one to use against bosses. That actually went really well. Water is... I kind of underrated a lot of the time. It can be really good with bosses sometimes. So let's go ahead and break that, get the last energy sphere. And go forward. I don't know if we got another boss or if this is the end. No, this looks like the end. Again, another peaceful, nighttime, cloudy area. I love this world for that. It's kind of cool. Alright, so now we are ready to take on the boss of this world. Should be pretty cool. That was a pretty cool intro, actually. You already know it's going to be awesome. Alright, so it takes care of all the energy spheres for this level, which is sweet. We're making pretty good progress on those. Now let's take on the boss. Alright, so let's see what they're going to give us. I'm not a big fan of Spark. But again, like I said, we'll see what they give us. Ooh, yes, they give us Fighter. Awesome. Alright, so let's go. Nice little build up here. Oh, sweet. Oh, I guess there's not a boss, we just get it. Yes, of course, we have to fight the Grand Doomer, the big daddy of all the Sphere Doomers we've been fighting so far. This guy's not too tough. He has mostly the same kind of attacks you've seen before. Just, you know, slightly bigger, pretty much. And you can see he's got a decent amount of health. And unfortunately, that little beam attack... Oh, crap. I could have guarded there, but I jumped and panicked. But, you know, Fighter is pretty good for this. It doesn't necessarily do a lot of damage at a time, but if he ever gets down like that and you can pull off the energy attack, you can do pretty decent damage. So, you know, that did all right. Whoa. Oh, crap. I didn't even see that coming. Well, I'm not necessarily doing the best. We're both pretty much about halfway here. Watch out for those. pretty easy to avoid just by jumping and hovering for a bit, so. And of course, being able to destroy those projectiles really helps. Ah. So yeah, pretty much being off the ground there will ensure you're safe. Try not to get eaten. Come on, only needs a couple more hits. Oh man, whoa, what's this? Oh crap. Yeah, so you kind of have to play things a little bit different here. You can see he's kind of developed this giant shield thing, so really there's only one way to hurt him, as we'll soon see. Right now we don't have the methods to do so. We're gonna dump the power though, because... crap. There, we're gonna get a superpower. And fortunately I'm really close to death, but... alright, there we go. Mmm! So yeah, you hit him with the superpower, and as you can see that takes off one block of his shield there. So, of course, we can also use it to destroy these little guys, which is pretty nice. There we go. Now, after the second one, he's going to try to take it from you, I believe. So we can go ahead and defeat these guys with it. Actually, you might keep it the whole time. I could be mistaken about that. The other good thing about the little guys is they will sometimes give you health recovery as well, so that's also pretty good. Alright, so I've taken down three of the four blocks of his shield, so only one more shot and he'll be wide open. It's awesome using one of these superpowers in a boss battle, you know? And the ending to this is so cool. Oh, crap. I believe you can hit him while he's doing that. There we go. Alright, so we've destroyed his shield. Down he goes. Oh man, I love that final hit. So cool. Nice, we finally restored his ship. Awesome. Alright, so let's see what he's got to say. Yeah, we did it. The lore's back in business. Everything's there. Alright, so yes, of course, if you remember, he promised us in a previous part, if we finished restoring his ship, he would take us to his home planet, which is Halcondra. Exists in another dimension, super far away, but the lore can fly us there in the blink of an eye. Back some snacks, yeah, pretty much. Thank you. Alright, so, well, we made it back to his planet, but it looks like we were shot down. Let's see what he's got to say. That dragon, its name is Landia. It's lived on this planet for ages, it's always been fast asleep. Recently, however, it awoke and went on a rampage. Please, you must defeat that crazy dragon. I'll ask a lot of you, but this is it, I swear. Yeah, that's what they all say. Alright, so yeah, that's Landia. No, I don't want to talk to you again. So yeah, he's shot us down, unfortunately, when we got here. Oh, wow, he actually was saying something different. But, okay, well, either way, we still need to defeat him. Our goal hasn't changed, so. Alright, I think that's gonna do it for this part, though. In the next part, we will take on the first word of Halcondra. So until then, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.